Welcome to Basic Thermodynamics class. So today we will discuss the new chapter. So chapter 2, that is a thermodynamic process. Thermodynamic process. In the last class we will discuss about, in the first chapter we discussed the thermodynamic properties and the perfect gas laws. The second chapter is the thermodynamic process. So previously we discuss about the process, state, path. So the continuation of the first chapter is the second chapter. If you are the perfect in the first chapter, so it is so easy to understand the second chapter also. So first we will discuss about the on the completion of the spirit, we are able to understand the thermodynamic process in gases. So expression for a work done in a constant volume process. So before going to the thermodynamic process, just I am telling one example. So I am giving a one question to you. So in the first class also, in the first chapter also, I will discuss about this example only. Just we recollect that example. So here the hot tea in a cup becomes a cold after some time. Why? So read the question carefully. Listen the question carefully. Hot tea in a cup becomes a cold after some time. So if you kept a coffee in a on the table for a after some time, observe that the coffee become a cold. Why? Because this is because this is due to transfer of a heat from a heat from tea to surroundings. Due to transfer of heat from tea to the surroundings. Here the system, here the what is in the first class we discuss about the system, surroundings, boundary. So here the heat is transferring from the system, surrounding to the system due to the heat transfer, due to the transfer of heat from T. So T is a system to the surrounding. So transfer of heat from system to the surrounding. So here the heat is transferring from the high temperature to the low temperature. That's why the hot tea in a cup becomes a cold after some time. So next example, water converts into a steam on heating. Water converts a steam into heating. Why? So due to the absorption of heat, so we are continuously giving heat to the system. So after some time the water in the container evaporates and the steam is going outside. So it is due to the absorption of heat. This is both above cases the state of substance is changing. Here the one is changing from one state to the another state. So what is this called is a thermodynamic process. So here the state one, the it is changing the state from one state to another state in each cases. That's why it is called as a thermodynamic process. So thermodynamic process, a change in the state of a system, a change in the state of a system during its interaction with the surroundings. Here the surroundings is called a thermodynamic process. So what is thermodynamic process means, we can tell as a change in the system. There is a change in the system. Observe that in a cup of a coffee is a observe after some time it becomes a cold because there is a change in the state of a system due to interaction with the surroundings is called a thermodynamic process. So these thermodynamic process, when a system interacts with its surroundings, a change its state takes place. This is known as thermodynamic process. So it is important for the 1 mark question or the 3 marks question. So in exam what will they ask, what is thermodynamic process? So you can write, when a system interacts with its surroundings, a change in its state takes place. This is called a thermodynamic process. So thermodynamic process mainly classified into two types. One is a non-flow process, second one is a flow process. So this non-flow process and the flow process also divide, there is a subdivision, can be analysis in a different types of also. So see, that is the thermodynamic process. So thermodynamics process, if you take this a pressure and volume, so here it is changing the state during its interaction from 1 to 2. So state 1 to state 2. Here the temperature from high temperature to the low temperature. So a change in a state of a system So during its interaction. So 1 to 2 is the process. 1 to 2 represents the process, and this dots represents the intermediate state, intermediate process. So this is called as a thermodynamic process. 1 to 2 represents the process. So see how it changes. This is the thermodynamic process. A change in the state from 1 to 2 during the interaction with the surroundings is called thermodynamic process. Next, so already in the first chapter we discussed about what is a thermodynamic process. So that is continuation is only the in the second chapter. So thermodynamic process. So move on to the next classification of thermodynamic process. In this, the first topic is the classification of thermodynamics. So, thermodynamic process. So, how do you classify thermodynamic process? Means that the two process. One, it is a non-flow process. Second one is a flow process. So, thermodynamic process are classified as a non-flow process and then a flow process. So, the term itself indicates as a non-flow. So, continuous flow and the flow process. Non-flow process and the flow is not in continuous is called a non-flow process. Flow process means the flow is continuous. So non-flow process occurs in the closed system. So already we discussed so what is the thermodynamic systems. So thermodynamic systems are the three types. One is a closed system, open system, isolated system. So this non-flow process occurs for a closed system process. So closed system process. In the closed system, what is the happening? Only that the heat transfer is takes place. No mass transfer is not takes place. So that is a non-flow process. This non-flow process. So the process occurs in a closed system. The process occurs in a closed system. This is a very important point. Transfer of a mass across the boundaries is prevented. So there is a no mass transfers in the closed system. Only heat transfers is there. How energy, however, can cross the boundary. So only heat energy transfer is there. No mass transfer is there. Flow process. Non-flow process continuation. So different non-flow process are in this chapter. Different non-flow process are the constant volume or isochoric process. We call another name of a constant volume is a isochoric process. Second one is a constant pressure or isobaric process. Constant pressure process or isobaric process. Third one, constant temperature or isothermal process. Fourth one, adiabatic or isentropic process. Fifth one, polytropic process. Sixth one, throttling process. Seventh one, free expansion process. So these are the different types of non-flow process. So non-flow process in the the second chapter covers all the seven process. So in one class we will discuss about the one process. So total how many process are there? Seven process. So non-flow process mainly related to the closed system. So closed system already we discussed about that heat transfer is takes place. That means energy transfer takes place across the boundary. No mass transfer permits the boundary. So the boundary can change, that the mass of the system remains a constant throughout the process. Here the mass not changing. Here the mass is a constant throughout the process. However, the energy cross the boundary. So in this chapter we are analyzing the seven different types of non-flow process. We are analyzing the first one is constant volume. So another name is called as an isochoric process. Second one, constant pressure or isobaric process. Third one, constant temperature process or isothermal process. Isothermal, or we call as in a hyperbolic process also, because the graph shape is in a hyperbolic. That's why we call as in a hyperbolic process. Fourth one is an adiabatic process, or another name is a isentropic process. Fifth one, polytropic process. Sixth one, throttling process. Seventh one, free expansion process. So with the 1 mark questions, they will ask what is the another name of a constant volume. So we can say another name of constant volume is a isochoric process. Another name of constant pressure is isobaric process. Another name of constant temperature is isothermal process. Adiabatic process means isentropic process. So the here isothermal, iso means same, thermal means temperature. So that's why called as a constant temperature. And isobaric, iso means same, bar means the units of the pressure. So that's why called as a constant pressure process. Isochoric, isochoric, iso means same, choric means volume. So same constant volume process. So this is the name indicates the isochoric means constant volume, isobaric means constant pressure, isothermal means constant temperature process. So in each class we will discuss about only one process. In the today's class we will discuss about the constant volume process and some numerical problems on the constant volume process or isochoric process or isochoric process. So here come to so next one is a constant volume process. So here the name itself indicates in the whole process we are keeping volume as a constant. So volume as a constant. So for this we will consider one example also. So just in a, if you take one bottle, in the bottle we fill it with water and we close the bottle with a cap. So here there is no mass is transferring this. So here that is an example for the constant volume process. In a constant volume process, the volume remains constant throughout the process. So the name itself indicates. So process, throughout the process we are keeping the volume as a constant. So throughout the process we are keeping the volume as a constant is called a constant volume process. So example is it, the gas filled in a closed vessel is an example of a constant volume process. So here the gas is not going outside because the vessel is fitted with a cap. So the gas filled in a closed vessel. So the closed vessel means closed system. In this, no mass transfer is takes place, only the energy transfer is takes place is the closed system. So the gas filled in a closed vessel is the example of the constant volume process. Since the volume of the system cannot change during the process, so there is a work done by the system is also equal to the zero. If there is no volume, if there is no volume of the system not change during the process, the work done by the system, work done is equal to the zero. I am taking this a constant volume. Is in a closed vessel. See, there is a closed vessel. This is inside the inside called is a system, outside outside is called surrounding. Which separate the system and surrounding is an imaginary or the real drawn is called as a boundary. So we are giving continuously heat to this, we are giving continuously heat here and no mass transfer is not taking place. So as far as the work done is, there is no work done. So the work done is equal to zero. Here the main thing is we have to consider is a closed vessel, it's a closed system. In the closed system itself indicates that the no mass transfer is takes place, only heat transfer is taking, that is the energy transfers across the system. So this is called a constant volume process. So heat is added to the system from outside. So by in the above figure we are giving heat to the system from outside. So the pressure and the temperature of the gases increases and there is no change in volume because we are closed at the container. Here the pressure and temperature of the gases are increasing but there is no change in the volume, but there is volume. So pressure is gone increasing. See, if you draw the PV diagram, it's a constant volume process. So this is a parallel to the y axis. So see, state 1 to state 2, the pressure is goes on increasing, pressure is goes on increasing but the volume remains constant. So this is a graph for the PV. So this is a parallel to the y axis, parallel to the y axis. As the temperature and the pressure increases but the volume remains the constant. See, observe that the pressure is changing from P1 to P2 means it is increasing. And the process is from arrow imprisons the path and P1 to P2 is the pressure is increasing. So this is the PV diagram for the constant volume process. So in the examination they will ask to draw the PV diagram for the constant volume process, means just draw the P on y axis, V on x axis. So here the volume is constant. Volume is constant means V1 is equal to V2, but pressure is increasing. So P1 is equal increasing to P2. So state 1 to state 2. So this is the graph, the PV diagram for the constant volume process. Constant volume process. So this is very important, is how to remember each process of a PV diagram and TS diagram. So constant volume process we call as is a isochoric process also. In this constant process, what is, we are keeping a volume as a constant throughout the process. As the temperature and the pressure goes on increasing, but the volume does not changes. Volume does not changes, and the work done is equal to zero. There is a no volume change. Here the V1 is equal to V2. So we know that the work done is equal to PdV. Integral PdV. So dV is nothing but the change in volume. Change in volume means V1 minus V2. So both V1 and V2 are equal, because that's why change in V1 when equal to V2 means dV is equal to 0. So that's why the work done is equal to 0. Work done is equal to 0. Next. So see, this is a PV diagram. We are giving heat to the closed system. Here this is the closed system. See, there is the closed system. No mass transfer is takes place, only heat transfer is takes place. PV diagram there like this. V is a constant, V1 is equal to V2, but the pressure is increasing from P1 to P2. So this is the TS diagram. The temperature also increases as the entropy increases. This is the TS diagram. Temperature increases, entropy also increases. So this is a constant volume process. So very important diagram for the constant volume process. You have to don't mug up that or don't remember like this. So simply say that what is constant volume is, throughout the process we are keeping volume as a constant. That's why V1 equal to V2. So just put mark V1 is equal to V2 and the pressure is increasing. So if you consider it is an 0, 0. So goes on means it is increasing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 like this. So pressure is increasing means just mark one point here, next another point, next another point. So join the dot here from state 1 to state 2. So it becomes in a straight line which is parallel to the y axis, which is parallel to the y axis. So there's a constant volume means the volume remains a constant throughout the process. Since the volume of the system cannot be changed during the process, is the work done by the gas is, it's a work done by the gas is equal to the zero. Work done by the gas is equal to the. Similarly, if heat is removed from the gas to the surroundings of the system at constant volume, the result of the decrease in pressure and temperature of the gas, there is no change in volume. In previous case, we are giving heat to the system. So that's why temperature and the pressure are increasing and volume remains a constant. In the same case, similarly, if you remove the heat, if you remove the heat which are giving to the system, then temperature and the pressure becomes down. Temperature and pressure comes decreases, but still there is no change in volume. So this is also very important. In previous case, we consider that if you are giving heat, then pressure and temperature are increasing, and that also that, but maintaining the constant volume. And if you remove the heat from the system, means that the temperature and pressure comes downwards, means temperature and the pressure are decreasing of the gas. Temperature and the pressure of the gas are decreases, but there is no change in volume. That's why we call it as it's a constant volume process. Constant volume process. So see, this is a graph. Previous graph, if you are giving a pressure, giving heat means the pressure is increasing from P1 to P2. So previously we put the P1 here, P2 here. Now in this case, we are removing heat from the system. Removing the heat from the system means the pressure is continuously decreasing. Pressure is decreasing and temperature is decreasing, but the volume in remains constant. So here see the graph. So here the P1 to P2, the temperature, pressure will comes down. Pressure will comes down. So the arrow is also different. The process state is from 1 to 2. So previously here it is a 1, here is the 2. In that case we are giving heat. In this case we are removing the heat. That's why the P1 and P2 will change, because the pressure is goes on decreasing, but the volume remains constant. So this is also very important graph. So when you, the two graphs are there, if you given the giving heat to the system is the pressure P1 to P2 increasing. If you are removing the heat, the pressure is decreasing from P1 to P2. But in the both the cases, the volume remains constant. In the both the cases, the volume remains constant. And the work done, so work done by the gas is equal to the zero. Work done by the gas is equal to the zero. And we know that in the first chapter we discussed that the work done is equal to integral PdV. So since the change in volume dV is zero, because dV nothing but V2 minus V1. V1 is equal to V2. That's why both V1 equal to V2 means it's so zero. Both V1 and V2 are equal means V1 minus V1 equal to zero, or V2 minus V2 equal to zero. So if you substitute this dV here zero, anything into 0 comes 0. Here the dV, we get dV as a 0. So we know that the work done W122 is a integral PdV. dV is equal to 0. So anything into 0 is 0. So work done W is equal to 0. So work done PW2, substitute this 0 in this above equation, integral P into 0. So work done is 0. So heat transferred or the heat supplied or heat rejected. So whatever the, if your heat supplied means the pressure and temperature is increasing. If you the heat is rejected, your pressure is decreasing. So we know that the non-flow energy equation, NFFE is a non-flow energy equation. According to the first law of thermodynamics, Q12 is equal to dU plus dW. So U2 minus U1 plus W122. So in this process we got the work done as a zero. So work done means zero means the heat supplied during the change from state 1 to state 2 is equal to internal energy during the change from state 1 to state 2. So Q122 is equal to U2 minus U1. Heat transferred is equal to internal energy in the constant volume process. Constant volume process. Here the heat is supplied from the heat is supplied during the change of a state 1 to 2. 1 to 2 represents the change of state from 1 to 2. So another. So we know that the U2 minus U1 is nothing but the MCV T2 minus T1 at constant volume. That's why we are writing in the CV. This CV is a specific heat at constant volume. So Q is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So for the doing the problems, the both important is the work done is a zero and heat supplied during the change is equal to change in internal energy. So that is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So already we did the problems in the first chapter also. But again, we will do some more problems. Thus, in a constant volume process, so heat transferred is equal to change in internal energy. This is a very important thing. So thus, in a constant volume process, heat transferred is equal to change in internal energy. So this shows that all the heat supplied to the gas is utilized to increasing the internal gas. So dQ is equal to dU. dQ is equal to dU. So pressure volume temperature relationship. So from till now we will dQ is equal to dU. dU is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So by using the perfect characteristic gas equations, such as pressure volume temperature equations. So PVT. So we know the general gas equation as a P1 V1 by T1 is equal to P2 V2 by T2. But here we are considering this a constant volume. Means V1 is equal to V2. So V1 is equal to V2 means, so the equation becomes P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. So when the gas is heated at the constant volume, V1 equal to V2. So we get V1 and V2 get cancels, and the remaining is P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. So therefore, the initial and the final states may be related by the equation like P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. And this process is also referred as the isochoric or isometric process also. Metric means meter cube. Meter cube unit is nothing but the volume. That's why constant volume process is also called as isometric process or isochoric process. So P by T is equal to constant. So that's the constant volume process is governed by the Geissler. So worked examples. So what are the formulas we learned in this? So pressure is a constant, so work done is zero. So by applying the non-flow energy equation for the constant volume process, we can write a Q is equal to du plus dw. So dw is equal to 0, dq is equal to u2 minus u1 is equal to mcv t2 minus t1. So by applying the gas equation, characteristic gas equation, p1 v1 by t1 is equal to p2 v2 by t2, where here v1 and v2 are equal. That's why we can write this as a p1 by t1 is equal to p2 by t2. So p by t is equal to constant, and the constant volume process is also called as an isochoric process or isometric process. So we'll do some two or three problems. So we will wind up the constant volume process. So here, 1 kg of air is heated in a closed rigid vessel. So see here, it is in a, they didn't mention it is a constant volume process. They mentioned it is in a closed rigid vessel. Closed rigid vessel itself indicates it is in a constant volume process. Closed rigid vessel, such that the temperature changes from 27 degree centigrade to 427 degree centigrade. So convert into Kelvin, or the difference means no problem. If you convert the into Kelvin, the difference is same, or if you put in degree centigrade also, the difference is same. Find the heat transferred and the change in internal energy. So find the heat transfer dq and change in internal energy means du, assuming r value. So r is a characteristic gas equation constant, 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Cp is equal to 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So this is the question. So first write the given data, read the question two times and write the question given data and write what are the formulas applicable to this question. So first read the question once. 1 kg of air, so mass is equal to m, mass m is equal to 1 kg, is heated at a constant rigid vessel. So it is in a constant volume process, such that its temperature changes from 27 degrees to 427 degrees centigrade. So T1 is equal to 27, T2 is equal to 427 degrees centigrade. Find the heat transferred. So dq is equal to question mark, du is equal to question mark, assume r, characteristic gas constant r, 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So here the unit they given is a kilojoule, and cp value in terms of kilojoule. So by using the specific heat and relation between specific heat and the gas constant, we can find the cv value also. So we know that cp minus cv is equal to r. So we know the value of Cp and R. So by using the equation Cp minus Cv, we can calculate the Cv value. So first, M is equal to 1 kg. M is equal to 1 kg is a closed rigid vessel. So that is a constant volume process. T1, 27 degrees centigrade. I am adding 273, is a 300 Kelvin. T2, 427 degrees centigrade. It is 427 plus 273, 700 Kelvin. Q122 process, question mark. U2 minus U1, question mark. R value 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. R 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Cp 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. Cv is equal to, you know, using the relation of the between specific heats and the gas constant value, Cp minus Cv is equal to R. Cv is equal to Cp minus R. We can write this as a Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So we want Cv only. So I am bringing the Cv to the left side and R to the right side. Then the equation becomes Cv is equal to Cp minus R. Substitute the Cp value and the R value, we will get Cv value. So Cp value is 1.005 minus 0.287. So using calculator, so do the calculations. 1.005 minus 0.287 means 0.718. So units, because the both the units are same, kilojoule per kg Kelvin, so this unit also kilojoule per kg Kelvin, 0.718 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. If you know that these two values by using the relation between specific heats and the gas constant value, we can find the Cv value. Cp minus Cv is equal to R. So Cv is equal to Cp minus R. Substitute the Cp value and the R value. So we will get the 0.718 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. But in the problem, they asked to calculate the heat transfer and the change in internal energy. So at the constant volume, so dq is equal to du. So dq is equal to du is equal to mcv T2 minus T1. Constant volume process, the work done is 0. So work done is 0. Heat transferred Q122 is equal to change in internal energy equal to mcv T2 minus T1. So we know the formula. So they are substitute all the values in the formula. We know in the given data, they given the M value. We calculate the Cv value, T2 and T1 ways. So substitute all this. 0.718 into 700 minus 300. So we will get 224.3 kilojoules. 224.3 kilojoules. This is the heat transfer. So in at constant volume, the heat supplied during the state 122 is equal to the change in internal energy. So change in internal energy is dq is equal to du. So change in internal energy is also 224.3 kilojoules. So this is the problem about the constant volume process. So read the question carefully and write the given data and underline what is the process, either it is a constant volume process or any other process, because total 7 processes are there. So in the first class we are discussing about only one process, it is a constant volume process only. So in the next class it will be a constant pressure process. So before doing the problem, we have to identify the problem belongs to which process. Problem belongs to which process and highlight that letter. In that problem, they given is a closed process. So closed means it is in a constant volume process. So in the constant volume process, the work done is 0. Work done is 0 and the heat transfer MCV T2 minus T1. So substitute all the values here. 1 into 0.718 into 700 minus 300. So 224.3 kilojoules, because the Cv value is given is a kilojoule per kg Kelvin, M value is in kg, T2 minus T1 is in Kelvin. So all the kg Kelvin, kg and the Kelvin will get cancelled and the remaining term is a kilojoule, remaining term is a kilojoule. So here that the at constant volume process, there is no heat transfer, there is no work done. That's why if you apply the non-flow energy equation at constant for a constant volume process, dq is equal to du plus dw. Here the dw is a 0. That's why dq is equal to du. So change in internal energy is nothing but the change in heat transfer during the state 1 to the state 2. So 224.3 kilojoules. So this is a problem. So yes, another problem also we will do. Go to the next slide. Here then. A certain gas occupies a space of 0.3 meter cube. So here they given the one space 0.3 meter cube at a pressure of 2 bar and the temperature of 77 degrees centigrade. It is heated at constant volume. So they given that the condition, they given that condition is in a constant volume. They given what is the condition here? The constant volume. So this process belongs to constant volume process until the pressure of 7 bar determined. A, temperature at the end process, temperature at the end process means T2, mass of the gas means M, change in internal energy. So these three we have to calculate. So read the question carefully. A certain gas occupies a space of 0.3 meter cube. So volume, initial state given the volume, pressure P1 and the temperature 77 degrees. So they given the P1 in terms of a bar. So P1 is equal to 2 bar and temperature is equal to 77 degrees centigrade. So we have to convert into the Kelvin. 77 plus 273 we get in terms of a Kelvin. And given it is heated at constant volume until the pressure of 7 bar. So P2 also they given in the same only. So P2 is equal to 7 bar. So determine the temperature at the end of the process. So they are asking to calculate the temperature at the end of the process. So end of the process means here the pressure is changing from state 1 to the state 2. So the pressure is increasing. The pressure is increasing means the temperature is also increased. So the answer should be more than 77 degrees. Here the pressure P1 to P2 is increasing. So temperature also should increase T1 to T2. So temperature should be more than 77 degrees centigrade and mass of the gas. So by using the characteristic equation PV is equal to MRT. So we can calculate the mass of the gas. So change in internal energy. So it is in a constant volume process. The change in internal energy dQ is equal to dU. So dU is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So first write the and the given the CP value also, CV value also. If the D given the in the problem, so we have to assume the CP and CV value because the standard CP and for the air are the constant specific heat, pressure and volume for the air are the, for the air it is a 1.005 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. CV is equal to 0.718 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So we have to remember the values of a CP and CV. So that's why they didn't give it in the problem. That's why I am assuming here CP and CV value. So first write the given data. First, volume V1 is equal to 0.3 meter cube. P1 2 bar. So I am converting into kilonewton per meter square. So we all know that 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. 1 bar is equal to 10 to the power of 5 newton per meter square. But I am writing this into the kilonewton per meter square. So I am splitting the 10 power 5 as a 10 square into 10 power 3. So 1 10 square I am putting here and a 10 power 3 I am writing as a kilo. So it becomes as a 2 into 100 kilonewton per meter square. 2 into 100 means it is a 200 kilonewton per meter square. If you have to write in terms of newton per meter square means simply 2 into 10 to the power of 5. But I am writing here in terms of a kilonewton per meter square. That's why I am splitting the 10 power 5 as a 10 square into 10 power 3. And 10 power 3 I am writing as a kilo and 10 square is a 2 into 10 square. It becomes a 200 kilonewton per meter square. Next, T1 is equal to 77 degrees centigrade. T1 is equal to 77 degrees centigrade. 77, I am converting degree centigrade into Kelvin. So 77 plus 273 becomes 350 Kelvin. Next, for the constant volume process, we know that the V1 equal to V2. In the problem, they mentioned it is in a constant volume process. So V1 equal to V2. So that is equal to 0.3 meter cube. And next, P2 is equal to 7 bar. Here also I am converting this bar into kilonewton per meter square. Simply multiplying with 100, we will get in terms of a kilonewton per meter square. So P2 is equal to 700 kilonewton per meter square. They asked to find the T2 value. So, and we assume the CP and CV value, and we know that R is relation between the specific heat and the gas constant is equal to CP minus CV is equal to R. Relation between the specific heat and the gas constant, CP minus CV is equal to R. So we assume the CP value and the CV value. So CP value is 1.005 minus 0.718. So it comes as a 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So by using the relation, we will get the R value. So R value is equal to 0.287 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So they asked whatever in the problem, what they asked to calculate the temperature, mass and the internal energy. So first bit is the temperature at the end of the process. Here the process is from state 1 to state 2. So they asked the temperature at the end of the process T2. So T2 is equal to question mark. So we know that, so it is in a constant volume process. So we know that P1 by T1 is equal to P2 by T2. So substitute all the values. So we want T2. So just cross multiply this. Just cross multiply this. So cross multiplication. So many students did mistake here only. Just cross multiply here. We want only T2. So just cross multiply. So T2 is equal to, T2 goes to that side, T2 is equal to P2 T1, so cross multiplication, I want only T2. So I am bringing this T2 to the left hand side and the remaining terms to the right hand side. So T2 is equal to P2 T1 divided by P1. So T2 is equal to P2. So cross multiplication, I am bringing this T2 to the left hand side, this P1 to the right hand side, and this T1 to the this side. So P2 T1 divided by P1. So many students did mistake here only the cross multiplication. So be careful doing about the cross multiplication. So if you don't know how to do cross multiplication, means simply put like this arrows. Simply put these arrows like this. So bringing this T2 to here and bring the P1 to this denominator. And bring this T1 to the P2. So total we want only T2. So T2 is equal to P2 into T1 divided by P1. So we all know the data of the P2, T1, P1. So substitute here. So P2 is equal to 700, pressure 350 into 700 divided by 200. It comes as a 1255. So it's a Kelvin. So if you want to convert into degree centigrade, means simply it minus the answer with the 273. Subtract answer with the 273, we will get in terms of a Kelvin. So 952. So observe that the temperature they given is a 700 Kelvin. So the pressure is increasing from P1 to P2. So here the temperature is also increases from T1 to T2. So if you get the temperature is less than T1, if you got the answer as a less than T1, so you did some mistake in that problem, and please check that. So where the mistake has happened. So here the pressure is increasing, means automatically the temperature should also increase. If the pressure is decreases, means the temperature should also decreases, because the pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. Because you are keeping as a volume as a constant, the pressure is directly proportional to the temperature. Pressure increases, temperature increases. Pressure decreases, temperature decreases. So in this case, the pressure is increases. So automatically the temperature should also increases. So T2 is more compared to the T1. So the answer is correct. To the mass of the gas. So we know that the characteristic gas equation PV is equal to MRT. So at state 1 we have to find, or state 2 we can take any one. P1 V1 is equal to MRT1, or P2 V2 is equal to MRT2. So anything is okay. So here I am taking P1 V1 is equal to MRT1. So students, you try to take P2 V2 is equal to MRT22, and both the mass M value is the same for that. So I am trying with P1 V1 is equal to MRT1. So you tried with the P2 V2 is equal to MRT2. So here we want only the mass. So mass means I'm putting mass here only and bringing this RT1 to the denominator. So it becomes M is equal to P1 V1 by RT1. P1 V1 by RT1. So I'm substituting P1 as a 200. Into V1 0.3, R value 0.287, T1 value 350. If you take P2 V2, means substitute that P2 V2 values and T2 values. T2 value we calculate from the A bit we got the T2 value. Substitute that A value and we get the same value. Check that both the values of the M are the same. Both the values of M are 0.597 kg. Change in internal energy. Next one is the change in internal energy. So change in internal energy is nothing but MCV MCV T2 minus T1. MCV T2 minus T1. So we got the M value in B bit, CV value 0.718, T2 in A bit, T1 is 350. So observe that the third bit. So if you do the first A bit and B bit correct only, then we will get the C bit correct. Because we take the M value from the B bit and the T2 value from the A bit. So if you got the values of the correct in A and B only, then the we will get the change in internal energy correct value. If you did mistakes in A and B value, so C will automatically will get the wrong answer. By knowing the formulas also, so we did mistakes in calculations, there is a no use. So be careful while doing the calculations. So M value is 0.597, CV value 0.718, T2 minus T1, I am taking in terms of a Kelvin. So total is a 375 kilo joules, 375 kilo joules. This one is a one more problem. So in this we have to calculate the T2 value first, another one mass, next finally U2 minus U1 is equal to MCV T2 minus T1. So if the D bit also asks, what is the change in heat transfer, means nothing but DQ, change in heat supplied or change in heat transfer is DQ. DQ is equal to DU, nothing but the 375 kilo joules, 375 kilo joules. So next we go to the another. So this is the last problem. Here I am taking this. I will tell this problem so fast because already we can do it three problems. So I will explain this problem little bit fast. 2 kg of gas occupying 0.7 meter cube had an initial temperature of 15 degrees centigrade. It was then heated at constant volume. So here that mention it is in a constant volume. So I am highlighting there is in a constant volume. So constant volume, they give the process which is under a constant volume. So until its temperature becomes 135. Here the temperature is increasing. 15 to 135. Here the temperature is increasing. How much the heat was transferred to the gas and what is the final pressure? They are asking. So we don't know the initial pressure also, and we know the we don't know the final pressure also. First we have to calculate the initial pressure, then after the final pressure. So first we have to write the data. So what is the data here? Mass M is equal to 2 kg, volume 0.7 meter cube. Initial temperature T1, 15 degrees centigrade. So T1 plus 273 is equal to 288 Kelvin. T2, 135 plus 273, 408 Kelvin. And they mentioned it is in a constant volume. Heated at constant volume. Next, how much heat transferred to the gas? What is the final pressure? So in the problem, they give to mention this R and CP value also. So they given that the R value and assume that the R is equal to 0.29. R is equal to 0.29 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. R is equal to 0.29 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. CP is equal to 1.01. So I am not writing the units here. That is nothing but 1.09. 1.09 kilojoule per kg Kelvin. So Cp R value 0.29, Cp value 1.09 kg Kelvin. So by using the relation between the specific heats and the gas constant, we can calculate the Cb value. So the first question, what is the heat transfer? So we all know the heat transfer is nothing but the change in internal energy. So change in internal energy is equal to mCv T2 minus T1. So we all know that m value, Cv value and T2 minus T1. So by doing the calculations, we will get 172.8 kilojoules volume. So at constant volume means P2 by T2 is equal to P1 by T1. So we don't know the P1 value. We don't know the P1 value and the P2 value. We know only temperature values. So before to calculate the P2 value, so first we have to calculate the P1 value. So they given the volume also. So volume means V1 is equal to V2, no problem. We can calculate either P1 or P2, no problem. Here I am taking this as a P1, or you have to take P2 also. If you take P2 means P2 is equal to MR T2 by V2. If you take P1 means P1 is equal to MR T1 by V1. So students, you try by taking this as a P2 is equal to MR T2 by V2. So we will get the P2 value. The P2 value is 338 kilonewton per meter square. Then substitute here, we will get as a P1 value as a 238.63 kilonewton per meter square. So substitute all the values in this equation, we will get this value. After that, P2 is equal to P1 by T1 is equal to T2, we will get the P2 value. Here see that the pressure is increasing. So see that as the temperature is increasing, as the temperature is increasing from 15 degrees to 135 degrees, here the pressure also increasing from 238 to 338. So the answer is correct. The answer is correct. If P2 is less than the P1, so you did some mistake. So then you have to check where the mistake has happened. So be careful while doing the problems. Write the formulas correctly and do the cross multiplications correctly. Do the problems. Be careful. So this is the regarding the constant volume process. This is the constant volume process. Summary. So in this field, what we discussed, so list of the thermodynamic process and constant volume process, extension of work expression of work done. So this is the thermodynamic process total is the non-flow process and the flow process. In the non-flow process, total 7 processes are there: constant volume, pressure, temperature, and adiabatic process, throttling process, polytropic process, free expansion process. So total 7 processes are there. In the first class, we will discuss, in this class we completed about the constant volume process. For that we derive the expression for the work done and heat and work done and heat transfer and internal energy and some problems related to the constant volume process. So what are the questions asked in the examinations means? Represents the constant volume process on PV diagram. So there are the two graphs. If you take pressure is increasing from P1 to P2, first point P1, next point P2. That is both the graphs are parallel to the y-axis only. The first graph represents pressure is increasing from P1 to P2 if you supply the heat. Or if you remove the heat, the pressure is go on decreasing. So pressure is goes on decreasing. Next, this is a problem. Read carefully and do it yourself. A vessel of 2.5 meter cube capacity contains 1 kg mole of nitrogen at 100 degree centigrade. If the gas is cooled to 30 degree centigrade, calculate the final pressure, change in specific internal energy, specific enthalpy. Gamma is equal to 1.4 and 1, they didn't given here the R value as a direct, they given as a 1 kg mole nitrogen is 28 kg. So read this question carefully and solve the problem yourself. In the next class we will discuss about the another non-flow process, that is a constant pressure process. We call it as an isobaric process also. So in the next class we will discuss the constant pressure and some problems related to the constant pressure process. So thank you so much.